good morning, you guys. So, oh, they got my old house boarded up. So somebody must not live there no more.
Looks like they kicked them out.
Okay, you guys. So today, gonna do something a little bit different for my pregnancy update video. I'm gonna do like a vlog style for this 38 week update, which just today I'm 38 weeks and 6 days. So this is my last week in my 38 weeks. And so I figure I'll just do like a vlog style update instead of a sit down one. So I'm actually on my way to take my husband to work, cause right now we're down to like one car, which is stressful. But you know, you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes until stuff gets better. So I'm on my way to take him to work. Here he is. He's on his way to work, and I don't have an appointment until 1:15, y'all. I really did not want to get up this early in the morning, but I had to because I need a car. And then after that, I have to just pretty much, instead of coming home, y'all know my doctor's appointments wear me out. Instead of being able to come home and go to sleep, I gotta wait around and wait for him and then come and pick him up from work, which is one of those things that sucks about having one car, because you pretty much just tied down to a certain location because the other person might need a ride or whatever. But yeah, that's what I'm gonna be doing today. I have a doctor's appointment at 1:15. So last night, you guys, I have been having like these menstrual cramps all day yesterday, and they weren't as bad. They just was really uncomfortable. Felt like, you know how you feel like a week before your period is about to come, you start getting a little bit of crampy, a little bit irritated. That's how I felt. And so last night, all of a sudden, I said around about 6 something, the cramps started coming like bad, and my husband wasn't at home, which really started to irritate me because I was hurting pretty bad, and that lasted for about an hour and a half. I had about 3 in every 30 minutes, and then after that, I didn't have any more for real like that. I had a few, but that was like really, really painful. And then I had to pee really, really bad, like really bad. I went to go pee, and when I wiped, I saw my mucus plug. So I lost a little bit of my mucus plug last night, and I wasn't really sure, but I kind of was sure that it was that. What made me not be sure is because there was no bloody show, like my mom and them said. Like, so I guess I only lost a little bit of it, but it looked like I had blew my nose when I wiped. So that happened, and then I started having a little bit of contractions. Leah was not, at first, like my last appointment, she was head down, but for this last week, she was not head down. She was across my belly. Last night, I guess I was in so much pain because she was moving head down, and so that's why I was hurting a lot last night. But this has been happening for like the last 3 or 4 weeks. I be in so much pain at night, like I be thinking, this got to, if this ain't labor, what the fuck? And then I wake up in the morning and I'm fine. This has been happening, so I don't know. I was hurting really bad. What do you think?
She coming.
Yeah. I don't know. But yeah, that's how it was last night. It was really intense, and I just thought maybe I was gonna go into labor. But I'm up and I don't have no pain at all. No pain at all. And that's how it's been for like the last, I say since I've been like 35 weeks. No, I say about since about 36, 37 weeks, it's been like that. Like, but next week I'll be due, so we'll see. I'll try to get some vlog footage in the hospital, in the doctor's office. I doubt if I do because I'm just not comfortable videotaping in public places like that, so. But I'll come back to you guys later and let you guys know what happened at the doctor's appointment. So right now I'm at home and I'm waiting for my good friend to come over. She has a, I just busted my lip. She has a pack and play for me that she wants to give me. So she's about to come and I'm about to set it up downstairs. And after that, I'm gonna try to get a good nap in before I have to go to the doctor's appointment because I'm really sleepy. So yeah, I'm just waiting for Michelle to pull up and drink some water. Probably watch a little bit of TV until I fall asleep. And that's about it. Y'all, sorry about my room. I know my room is junky. I have to come back and straighten up, but I'm about to run out here to my doctor's appointment real quick. But I wanted to give you guys a view of my baby bump real quick. Since this is a vlog and not a sit-down update. Those are clean clothes. I'm actually changing my sheets today and putting those clothes up, so don't worry about that mess. And I didn't make my bed up because when I come back, I'm changing my sheets. But, yeah. These are some maternity pants I got on. Ooh, y'all. It takes me so long to get dressed. I was putting on my slides, my Nike slide-ins. I just can't really do the shoes right now, you guys. But, yeah, this is the baby bump at 38 weeks. Oh, whew. Whew, goodness. All right, you guys, I think I'm going to be a little late to my doctor's appointment, and I got up on time. I just be moving so slow now, and my time management sucks right now because I just be moving so slow. My doctor's appointment is about 15 minutes away. I should have left about 10 minutes ago. My appointment is at 1:15. It's 12:57, so we'll see. We'll see how this goes. But I cannot record inside the doctor's office at all. I signed a thing that says no videotaping. And it's a big old sign that say no video recording. So I cannot tape inside the doctor's office, which, let me turn mid condition down. I wish I could record up in there, but I can't. I agreed not to, so yeah, I'm on my way to the doctor's appointment. I really feel like there's probably a faster way for me to get there, but I think I take the long way. I'ma try this other way real quick because I think the way that I go is probably a little long than going up this way. You know what, I probably should have just went straight down, but anyways, I'm on my way. If I get there, I should get there probably right at 1:15 because it only takes about 15 minutes to get there. But y'all, I'm just wanting to see, as much as I hate being checked to see if I'm dilated, because that stuff is really painful, I'm really, really curious to know, like, all this stuff that I've been going through, is it at least getting me dilated and getting me efface? I hope it ain't all in vain, this pain, because it has not been nice. It has not been nice at all. I wanted to stop and get me a burrito from the taco truck around the corner from my house, but I didn't have time. And plus, I'm gonna give me some fish after I get done eating from Mad Jack's over here by my doctor's office. So, I live on 16th Street. My doctor's office is on 63rd Street. So, we got a little ways to go. I'm just on 23rd Street now. So, we got a little ways to go. And then after this, I'm probably gonna hang around a little bit and go pick my husband up from work so that I don't have to come all the way home and then get all the way back out. Because once I'm in the house, I want to just be in the house. I'm going to show you guys when I get back home the little pack and play my friend brought over. Actually, it's Leah's godmother, Michelle. She brought over for her. And she actually brought Leah's bassinet too. So, yeah. Other than that, you guys, today's a pretty boring day. Nothing exciting in my life. At all. That's why, you know, vlogging is kind of hard for me because I really don't do much. But then again, I am pregnant. That could be the reason why. Yes, I really feel like this way is faster than the way I was taking. I really do. I really do think coming all the way up this way and then coming back down is faster than the way I was taking. Because ain't that many lights. But anyways, yeah, I'm hoping they'll say, like, girl, yes, you are 4 centimeters dilated. But I doubt it. I doubt it. But I'll talk to you guys in a minute. Bye. Okay, you guys. So, I just left my doctor's appointment. I was in there for a little while because my doctor actually had to leave to go deliver a baby. And then he has another patient actually in labor right now. So my appointment was about 45 minutes late. About 45 minutes late. Wasn't too bad. But got some news that I was not expecting to get today. So my doctor actually recommends that I get induced Tuesday. So I'm getting induced on Tuesday, February the 14th. So basically how he explained it to me is that I'm going to come to my regular doctor's appointment on Tuesday at 11. He's going to check me again. And he's going to send me over to the hospital to start my induction, to be induced. Like, the hospital is right across the street from the doctor's office. But he said he'll probably schedule my induction for that evening. Goodness gracious. Y'all, I was not expecting that. The reason why I went ahead and decided to get induced is because I am measuring really big. I'll be 39 weeks tomorrow, but I'm measuring like 40 and a half is what she said. So I'm measuring almost 2 weeks big than what I am, and that's been a while. But my doctor hasn't made like a big deal of it, so I haven't been tripping. So he was like, you know, if you want to be induced, I'm like, well, it's not something that I really care to do, but I mean, it's okay with me. So God, I'm going to the hospital. I would like that she might come before then, because like I said, I've been having like contractions and stuff. I lost my mucus plug already and stuff like that. So she might come this weekend and I probably won't even have to be induced. But I would have loved to have that water breaking experience and stuff like that. But it kind of works really good. I don't know if I told you guys this, but my husband just recently got a really good job working for the city. And he's on a really, really strict 6 month, is it 90 days or 6 months? Yeah, 6 months. 6 months probational period. So after 6 months of working with the company, they'll go ahead and evaluate him and see about if he has any like absences, lateness, you know, the typical stuff. But see, it's really, really strict, and so he can't really miss any days. Now they know he's pregnant, and they know I'm pregnant, and we're going to be having a baby this month. They told him that before he got the job, and he does have 3 emergency days that he can use, and he really wanted to use those days for when the baby comes. So it's kind of good that he can plan, because next week it's President Day, and so he'll be off. If I had a baby Tuesday, he can use his 3-day his be off Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, and he don't have to come back until next Tuesday, the following Tuesday, because President's Day, he'll have a 3-day weekend. So it kind of works out for my husband. So he can be a part of the baby's birth and delivery, and not have to feel like he gotta leave and go back to work and all this kind of stuff. So having her on Tuesday, being induced on Tuesday, because he's still gonna be able to go to work on Tuesday, because I'm not gonna get induced until that afternoon, to that evening. So he'll go to work Tuesday. He'll go ahead and be off Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday for me. And the unfortunate thing about it is it's unpaid, and right now his income is the only income coming in, because I'm not working and I'm not doing makeup or anything right now. So it's just really exciting. So we'll get induced on Tuesday. So what I'm doing right now is I'm about to go and get me some fish from Mad Jack's, because I haven't ate anything since this morning. And I'm gonna eat that, and then I'm gonna go pick my husband up from work, and we're gonna go home and, you know, get stuff ready for the baby. I'm so nervous. God, I cannot believe it. It does not seem real. And Leah is definitely head down. She's in the right position. It's just exciting. You know, my first baby. I really don't know what to expect, but I'm okay. So, okay, it's good to be able to tell your family like what day to expect her, so they can plan accordingly too. So yeah, let me go in here, cause girl, this is Mad Jax. If you from Kansas City, y'all know they do not play. And so I'm not gonna, definitely not gonna record up in here, girl, cause they'll probably take my camera. So let me go here and get me some fish and a cake, and I'm gonna sit in my car and eat that, and then go get my husband. Have you guys listened to Bruno Mars' new CD? It's really good. It's really, really good. This is a really good album, you guys. Shout out to Bruno Mars. I think she gonna come this weekend for sure.
Well, if you do like I tell you, then yes, she gonna come this weekend.
If you don't come.
You say throw Lee, light some candles and throw Lee on the bed.
Okay, yep.
that's hilarious. I'm gonna tell her. I said, my mama said, you need to bang my back out.
That's what he need to do. That's what he need to do.
Oh man, Vanessa said she gonna be there.
Yeah, she just called me. She's, I know, so excited.
I know. Woo, I'm nervous, mama. I'm nervous.
Girl, you got it.
But my doctor said that like this is a completely healthy pregnancy, so he's confident. I wonder, I think she's gonna look like Shamia. I really do. I got a feeling.
She look like little Ronnie.
You think so?
Hell yeah, because you can't stand that little boy.
Uh-huh, that's my arch nemesis. He was laughing the other day. I was like, tell him to shut the hell up. His voice is making
us. Yeah, that's what he's going to look like. That's so funny. Look like little Ronnie.
That's so funny. His birthday is on the 18th. They birthday is. Mm-hmm. She was due on the 16th. She was due 2 days before his birthday, but he going to induce me on Tuesday, so... Yeah, he said she might not come on Tuesday, but for sure by Wednesday morning she'll be here.
Okay.
Cause, yeah, so it's gonna be like Tuesday night when I come in there.
Okay.
Whew. Oh my God, I'll text you guys and let y'all know all the details.
Okay, baby.
All right, love you, mama.
Love you too, baby.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
In the back. I keep messing with Lil Ronnie, mm-hmm, and be like, they're gonna have their birthdays next year at Chuck E. Cheese together. Oh, you wanna play skee ball, son?
Put your seatbelt on, baby.
Here you go, son. You wanna play skee ball? You and your little sister?
You excited? It kind of works out, you think? I told your mom. You told her already?
I ain't talked to nobody, man.
What?
It was hot as. It was hot as hell in that mugging room.
Oh, it's a...
You fall asleep. Like, I couldn't... I was just like, oh, my God.
They about to get hit.
Yeah. I'm going to take you home. I got to go get her from practice. I don't know if practice ends at 5 or 5:30. I know you
want to go home. You want to go home and lay down. But, yeah, Brian had asked me about a humidifier.
Yeah.
I said, yeah, she need one.
Yeah, he knows. I said a humidifier.
Brian and Ronnie up there talking about a humidifier. I said, well, we do need one. I was just going to take the one from downstairs.
Maybe we should get another car seat.
Get another car seat?
Yeah, from when I get my car.
Oh. Who going to get the car seat? Why would you do that?
What?
You ain't got no car yet.
I'm going to have one.
Well, yeah, we can. We'll cross that bridge when it get here. We don't need to do it. I just say a 6-month clothes and a humidifier. That's what she needs.
That's what I told her too.
Baby, you all up on that car? So yeah, my baby. So that's her butt right here. That's so funny. And her little feet is over here.
So it's funny. And what's really funny is the fact that they say that she's gonna be big. I tried to tell you.
Well, they didn't really measure her. My doctor doesn't really do that.
But they say she's gonna be a pretty good sized baby.
They say she's healthy. Yeah. I'm measuring, I'm 39 weeks tomorrow, I'm measuring 40 and a half. So, it's pretty big. I was just excited to get it over with. I didn't really plan to be induced. That's why you don't never like say what you gonna do or what you're not gonna do, because when he asked me did I want to be induced, it was just like, he was just like, it's up to you. I don't know, I just said yeah.
drive you free with our unlimited gig plan.
I'll just say, yeah. And I didn't even realize Tuesday was Valentine's Day until you said something. That shows you. Tells you about I thought for some reason I thought Valentine's Day fell on Thursday.
Well, I mean, I already got your roses, so it's
okay. Oh, okay, yeah. It's a no-brainer. Earlier today, y'all, I had he's such a liar. I had tricked him. I had sent him a picture of some roses, and I'm like, oh my god, babe, thank you so much. But he didn't respond, so I said, let me call him. And so then I said, baby, thank you so much for the roses. He like he was quiet for a little bit, and he said, what makes you think I sent them? And I said, well, the letter said, I love my wife to my dear wife or something. I said, and he said, oh, yeah, yeah. They came a little earlier than I expected. And then he's like, I'm like, really? What you was getting for Valentine's Day? He's like, well, I didn't know when you was going to have a baby or not. So I was trying to get him by this weekend. I'm like, you're a fucking liar. I was gonna keep it going, but I couldn't. He's just, oh god, he's funny, y'all. Oh, he's freaking funny. What time is the game? Oh, ain't no game today?
Nah, her next game is Friday.
Oh, ain't none on Tuesday?
Yeah.
Oh.
When she do.
Oh, well, that sucks. So yeah, I got heartburn, and I'm about to go home and lay down, you guys. I really don't like to blog. Oh, raise my window, because I think they can't hear me. I really don't like to blog because I feel like it don't be much to talk about because my life is boring. But I'm definitely going to record the whole getting induced thing for my channel. So if she come before Tuesday, that'd be cool. But this is probably going to be the end of this vlog. I don't see any other reason to pull it out for anything. So, I'll see you guys in a few. Bye.